And we are back, and we just finished watching 1986's baller classic, Aliens, by, what's his name? James Cameron.
That guy.
That guy, yeah. Okay, let's do this again.
Never did anything after that movie.
Cut. And we are back, and we just finished watching 1986's Aliens, rated R, with a runtime of 2 hours and 17 minutes. This movie is directed by James Cameron, with screenwriting credits to James Cameron, David Giler, and Walter Hill, based on characters by Dan O'Bannon and Ronald Shusett. This is the second part of the original Aliens, which came out in the 70s, that was directed by Ridley Scott.
Well, the first one was just Alien.
Alien, right. And this one is Aliens, plural. And a really good sophomore effort by Cameron, although, and we've had this conversation before, the first one is definitely more horror, sci-fi horror.
The first one's sci-fi horror, this one is sci-fi action.
Action, right. Yeah. Which is nice. I mean, I think I saw this in the theater and I was not disappointed at all by this film. I think I expected it to be more like the first, but I actually enjoyed this quite a lot.
Who doesn't enjoy Aliens? It's like one of those.
I'm sure there's some contrary people.
I remember
out there.
Back in the day, everybody's like, sequels suck. They're never as good as the original. Aliens was excellent.
Yes.
It's a different type of movie, so I can't really compare the two, say one's better than the other. But it's a great movie. There's great characters in it. It's got a nice, tight story. Excellent performances by everybody. There's great creature effects by Stan Winston. It's like crazy. You look at it and you're like, those are puppets. Those are people in costumes.
Yeah.
And the way it's filmed and the way they move and all of that just works so well.
So well.
Because if you look at like the Alien, it's a pretty big clunky thing, and
but it's ferocious
to make
looking.
That to make that thing move the way they make them move in this movie is pretty impressive.
Yeah.
They're like jumping from wall to wall back and
the
forth.
Way they like glide in those tunnels and stuff. Ugh, I remember like the first time I'd seen this. Cameron did Terminator in 84, which is also another baller classic. That movie too, I remember the first time I watched it, all I could think about was how much anxiety I had watching the film and why wouldn't the Terminator die?
And now you watch this one,
it's sort of very similar because it's like, it's just nonstop. I mean, nothing beats like the first time. The first time you watch a movie like this, it's just so over the top. It's like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And I remember sitting in the cinema and thinking, this doesn't stop. I'm going to have a stroke watching this. It just doesn't stop. I'm going to go around the table and get impressions. Olive G, what'd you think of this movie?
I thought it was good.
Yeah, what'd you like about it?
The costumes.
The costumes, okay.
Like how the aliens look really cool.
The special effects with the aliens.
Even though this is a really old movie, wasn't that great back then.
Yeah, I mean, for a film that came out back then, the special effects, they're still pretty good, right? I mean, the spaceship stuff looks a little off, but the aliens themselves, they look great, right?
Yeah, yeah. And also the fact that you got to stay up late tonight.
I really couldn't care less.
Yeah. All right. All right. Just wondering.
Did you think the queen looked good?
Yeah.
Yeah. That thing was massive.
Oh my God. So scary.
And it was a puppet.
Yeah. How many people were like
piloting
that thing?
There must have been a ton of people piloting that thing.
And also like that egg sack thing that just came off.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You are so very welcome.
What was that about? I don't even remember saying A-L-E-X-A.
No. She just wants to butt in.
Maybe she can. Gigi, what'd you think of this film?
That was good.
Yeah, you liked it? Did you have a favorite character in this film?
Probably Ripley.
Ripley. Ripley is a boss bitch. She is just, oh my God. I think at one point I wanted to name my child Ripley.
I think a lot of people named their kid Ripley after this movie came out.
She really is. I mean, she's smart. She's beautiful. She's tough.
Yeah, she takes charge.
I mean, charge.
When Gorman completely screws the pooch up. and just bungles everything, she's just, get out of the way, and she starts driving that, like, monster tank.
Yeah.
And when her and Newt were trapped in the room, she was able to free them.
Yeah, she had the foresight to turn on the, so the water things would go off. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she, I mean, and even at the end, she gets into that suit.
The big rescue, oh yeah, and then the power loader suit as well.
Yeah, yeah. She's like so amazing. It's so funny because she's such an iconic character in movie history. I mean, the subsequent Alien movies were just okay, but these first two, so, like, those, carry those are, the franchise
are,
for me.
Those are better left forgotten. Alien 3 was just garbage, and Alien 4 or whatever they called that movie.
Oh, my God. Alien Resurrection? I don't even remember.
What the hell was going on?
I've blocked that all out from my mind.
Just make Aliens. We don't have to worry about a script.
I mean, as far as I'm concerned, it's just the first and the second movies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those are the only Aliens movie that exist. And these new ones that come out, they feel like they're like a completely different story.
Different story, yeah. I mean, Prometheus was interesting.
Prometheus was the first one, and then there was Covenant. Yeah.
I refuse to watch Covenant.
Prometheus was interesting, but you had to get past the fact that, like, all of these brilliant scientists on this ship were just
idiots.
Bungling idiots. Yeah. Just so stupid. The navigator is the guy who gets lost. He's got little floating balls that map out everything in the alien ship, and he's the guy who can't figure out how to get out of it. Mm. Come on. All right, we'll review that one on a different day.
Yeah. Olive G, did you have a favorite scene in this film?
I think I don't actually have a favorite scene that much.
Okay.
I mean, I was the first time I watched this, I watched that scene where they were trapped in that room with that, what were they called?
The facehuggers.
Oh, God. Like, I was really scared that they weren't going to make it out alive.
Yeah. Yeah. I think the first time I saw this film, too, I also thought,
Those things look good, too. The way they made them skitter around.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I think I think I've told you guys this story, but I saw the first one in the movie theater, and she talks about that scene when they're going on the mission with all the military people, how the guy had the face hugger and then it came off and they thought he was fine. And then at dinner, they're all together and this thing had incubated in him and all of a sudden it flew out of his chest. Mm-hmm. And as a young child watching this in the cinema, I was
horrified
to the point where I did not want to eat because I thought that something was going to get, like, in my brain, like, it didn't dawn on me that, oh, the face hugger would have to come on my face in order to impregnate itself inside of me. To me, it was like, oh, he got it while he was eating. So guess what? I'm not going to eat, which was not the thing to say to Spanish parents growing up. So for like a week, I caught a beating because I didn't want to eat. And that wasn't acceptable. But I digress. So what do we think about the Burke character? Brilliantly played by Paul Reiser. He looks like a scumbag. He acts like a scumbag. He is a scumbag. And he gets his just desserts.
In the beginning, he seems like a nice guy. He's the guy who seems to care about her.
Is he, though?
No, he doesn't. He's not. It's all a ruse.
You've never liked Paul Reiser. No, why are you making excuses?
I thought he was great in this.
He was great in this.
Because you hated
him. Hated him just so very much. Just so very much. Yeah. I am completely unacceptable. Who do you think is a bigger villain in this, Gene? The aliens or Burke and the company that he represents?
I don't know.
No? Well, okay, so let's think about it. I mean, the aliens are, they're just trying to live and survive and procreate, right?
Yeah, they're just existing.
They're just existing, whereas the company wants to make a profit, mm-hmm. right? So we're talking about corporate greed.
Yeah, I mean that. Well, especially in Burke's case, because he's we all make out with a percentage.
Yes. So you know, this
get exclusive rights. If he would have gone through the proper channels, all these people would have been involved, and nobody would have gotten exclusive rights, and that was all he cared about.
Right. He had a hidden agenda, but again, obviously spurned on by the company. I'm sure this wasn't his plan. Well,
that's a holdover from the first movie, because the first movie was, you know, primary objective was to get the specimen, all other objectives secondary, including the lives of the crew.
Right.
That's what Ash's mission was.
Was right.
And who's then Ash?
In the first, movie, he was the synthetic, the android.
Yeah, we were talking about him, Ian Holm.
Yeah. And turns out only Ripley and the cat survived.
Yep.
Yes.
The cat triumphed through the
Jonesy.
Movies.
Jonesy. Aw.
Why did they bring a cat?
Because they wanted to bring a cat along.
Yeah.
But why?
Why do we have a cat?
Like, why?
I don't know. That's a good question.
No, why would you bring a cat to this alien planet that was basically?
Well, they
had no idea what was.
Their mission wasn't to go to the alien. They were a mining ship, and then they were on their way home when they got a distress signal. And the rule was that if you get a distress signal, you gotta stop. go check it out, and answer it.
Yeah.
So when they went, then they ended up running into the alien.
Olive G, I don't think I asked you. Who was your favorite character in this film?
Ripley?
Yeah, she's pretty badass. But also Private Vasquez? Vasquez was cool, no?
Yeah, I think everybody liked Vasquez.
Yeah. So some strong female characters, even Newt in some ways. There's that great scene where Ripley says this kid survived longer than
17 days.
Yeah. Without any training, without any weapons. And then Hudson. Yes, and then Hudson's like, we'll put her in charge. Every time I see this movie, I miss Bill Paxton.
Yeah.
It's such a shame that he's not with us anymore.
Bill Paxton was awesome.
He really is. He died.
The guy who played Hudson, he passed away.
Yeah, he had surgery or something and it went wrong or something.
Something like that. I don't know the details, but he's the one.
I think that, what was her name?
Newt?
No, like the Ripley? Other woman that died.
Vasquez?
Vasquez, she made a worthy sacrifice.
Yes.
Her and Gorman.
Yeah, Gorman redeemed himself at the end.
Gorman redeemed himself at the end there. Yeah, I mean, top to bottom, just really good storytelling, good special effects. I mean, for 1986, I feel like this movie still holds up.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
We watched this on the USA app.
The USA app showing stuff that's on Sci-Fi.
So
it's got commercials.
And
it's like
edited.
They edited the language. I'm sure they probably cut out some scenes.
Yeah.
There was a couple of scenes.
They blurred out Vasquez giving the finger. I was like, what is the point of this?
I don't know.
It's
into a TVG movie?
I don't know. It was so weird. So this movie played for longer than it should have. And then I was kind of PO'd about all the editing. I'm like,
also there's the fact that the streaming service didn't get the time right.
They botched the timing for the commercials.
Oh my goodness! Yes,
5 seconds.
They'd cut it mid sentence, and then after commercial, it would come back, play for about 5 more seconds, and then fade to black, which is where the commercial was supposed to go.
Yeah.
And then it would fade back into the movie.
Yeah, USA, get yourself together. I don't know what is going on. That was pretty bad.
Whatever. If we weren't so cheap, we could have watched it for
We have the DVD.
Yeah, we also have the DVD, but the DVD is somewhere unknown.
Lost in the garage or the basement. I don't know.
One or the other.
Or in your office. I'm going to go around the table and get numbers. Gigi, 1 to 10, what would you give this film?
8.
What about you, Olive G?
8, too.
8?
I'd give this like an 8.5.
I, too, would give this an 8.5. I think I would probably give the first one a 9 or 9.5 or maybe even a 10.
I would put it in the 9.
But this,
range.
I would say 8.5 for sure. I mean, it really good sophomore try for this film. I was really surprised that Cameron did it. Sometimes you think with movies like this where there's going to be a sequel that the original director would have taken a crack at it. Ridley Scott made a great first picture. So, but it's still not... It doesn't take away from the whole experience because I think Cameron did a really fantastic job with this.
Yeah.
And it's interesting that it just leaned heavily into action. And it's relentless, much like Terminator. It was just like craziness after more craziness after more craziness.
I think I remember reading somewhere that like when he pitched the movie, he basically just like took out, there was like a whiteboard and he wrote the word alien on it. And then he just looked at the people in the room and just put an S at the end, and that was it. That was the entire pitch.
Is that true? That's amazing.
I don't know if it's true, but that's like one of the stories.
That's
about
amazing.
Aliens,
well, you know, I mean,
it could have been a Saturday Night Live sketch. I don't know.
possibly. But I feel like, I think at that point, I mean, he had just come off Terminator, which did really well and was such a good movie. Oh my God, that's another one that holds up. But I think that this film, it's just really good. It's just really, really good. I mean, there's really no critique here. I mean, I can't think of anything that I disliked in this movie. Can you?
Not really. I mean,
other than presentation of this film.
If there was like the only thing I would ever say is if they ever like remastered this, maybe like touch up the special effects on the spaceship.
Because it looks
those scenes, you could see they're using like the old style green screen sort of stuff, and those particular scenes. There's plenty of scenes with the ship where it looks fine, where you could see it was just some sort of big thing on a crane or something. But the ones where it's sort of like flying through the atmosphere and whatnot, those look a bit dated. But it's a great movie. Dude,
yeah.
I mean, you gotta realize it was the 80s, you know?
Yeah.
Be a little forgiving.
But still,
the creature effects are brilliant.
Amazing. But still, for a movie from 1986, this still holds up. I mean, there's really great storytelling as far as sci-fi, as far as an action piece, as far as like even bits of social commentary where you talk about, again, corporate greed and how that affects everybody in this thing. I mean, the company basically sent all these people there to die, and they knew. So, yeah, I mean, if you haven't seen it, we all highly, highly recommend 1986's Aliens. It's playing on the USA app, which is where we saw it, with commercials. I'm not going to say limited because it felt more than it should have been.
Uh-huh. And it's also for rent.
It's also for rent and to buy on many other platforms. So I think that's it. We are going to sign off and bid you all a good night.
Good night.
Night.
Good night.